Memory plays a major role in any digital circuits. So you can consider any system. So along with having so many controllers and so many hardware, unless we store the data in a particular place, the desired value cannot be retrieved and we cannot store the value for further processing. So that understanding memory becomes important while designing the any digital circuits. Let us try to understand, okay, what are the different types of memories and what are the classifications of memories. So we can classify memories as first static memory and dynamic memories. So whenever the power is on, so assume that, okay, power, because memory is also memory is nothing but storing the value that is logic high or logic zero, that will be usually stored in a okay, active devices. So whenever you have an active device, we know that we need to have the power supply to be given, so power should be there. So assume that you have a circuit and then the power is being applied to that particular memory circuit. Whenever you have the power being applied to a memory circuit, so this is the memory and power is given to this. So as long as power is there, if you are written some values like, okay, 100, whatever the value that is to be stored, if it is stored in this memory, as long as this power is there, if these stored values are there intact, like, okay, whatever the value that you have stored in n number of bits, if they are retained as long as power is there, we call it as static memories. So whatever value that you are storing here as 10 will be there forever as long as you give the power, as long as power is there. So no need to repeatedly say that, okay, the value that is stored is 1010. So once you store it and then give the power, it will be there forever. It will be there forever as long as power is there. We call it as the value is stored in a static memory. That is, if you are storing it as 1, that 1 will be held for any duration as long as power is there. Whereas its counterpart, I'll again have the power. So there is a power that is being given to this memory. So this memory, you have written 1 and zeros, some bit values, and assume that this is a dynamic memory. If this is a dynamic memory, even though power is on, you have stored the values of 1 and 0. If you see after some time, you may not get the stored values, meaning these dynamic memories may not hold the value of these stored values 1 and 0 for a longer time, even though the power is on, because in case of static memories, we will be having a feedback, you'll be having a hold feedback. So as we discussed in the earlier flip-flops, so assume that you have stored a value of 1 in a particular thing. Suppose if you are there in a feedback loop, that 1 will be keep on circulating here and you want to keep the value of 1 as a static value as long as power is there. But in case of dynamic memories, even though the power is there, even though the values of memory that is memory bit that is to be stored is there in the memory bit, if the time duration of accessing that value is long, so there is a probability that the value of 1 that is there maybe get discharged. So assume that if it is stored in a capacitor, this is how the dynamic memories will work. Assume that this is stored as 1, the power is on. Suppose if you take long time for after long time, if you are reading this, because of some reason, because of the leakage, assume that it is connected to MOSFET, because of the leakage, the this charge that is stored in this capacitor maybe get discharged, so you may end up with losing the data. So in case of static, when the power is there, because of this feedback loop, the values of 1 and 0 will be held as long as power is there. In dynamic, in spite of power is there, the value may be lost. In order to avoid that, what will happen in case of dynamic memory is that it will be keep on pre-charging, it will be rewriting the values often so that the value will be retained as it is. Next, okay, this is one category of memories, static memory and dynamic memory. Let us see what is this, okay, read-write memory. This is read write memory is one where you can able to read the value onto a particular bit, and you can as well as write. So you can able to read the value that is stored in a particular bit, and you can able to write also. So assume that you have a capacitor. If there is a possibility that you can able to write some value onto this, store some charge, and you can able to read out from this, then we'll say that it is possible to read as well as write the memory. And usually these read write memories are volatile in nature. So they are all volatile in nature, meaning so this value will be of course, when I say volatile, there is a possibility that because it is stored in a capacitor like stuff, so it may be just losing the charges. So this read write memories are volatile in nature. So the counterpart of this read write memory is read only memory. So this is read only memory where you are only reading the thing, only reading. You don't have an access to write repeatedly. Of course, you can able to write only once. So but you can able to read n number of times. Assume that you have a particular thing to be used very often, which need not be changed. Then in such cases, you just store those type of information in ROM so that you are not supposed to change the value. So some default settings can be put in this ROM where you're not changing them often. So you'll be storing them at once. So since it should be used very often, we just simply read the values. Since it should be retained for long time, they are non-volatile. They are non-volatile memories. They are not supposed to lose the values. That is, if it is one, it will be held for one as long as the memory is there. So this is how it is possible to make it read only memory, where you can only read. You have to write it only in the beginning. So and it is a non-volatile memory. The values will not be lost. Sometimes it happens that you want to have a non-volatility, and you may have to have this read-write operation also. You can see in this non-volatile ROM memory, you are not having the option to write very often. So having the advantage of non-volatility and having the access of writing, we have something what is known as non-volatile read-write memory. So it is still non-volatile. You can able to read as well as write. The memories that come under these type of non-volatile read-write memory are this is electrically programmable memories. So electrically programmable ROM. Of course, this ROM, whatever I talked about, that is read-only memory, is usually PROM, P-R-O-M, where you are programming in the beginning to retain the value. It is programmable read-only memory. What is this is, this is still a ROM, that's why it is non-volatile. Since you can able to write it, because now it is electrically programmable ROM. So it's a read-write non-volatile ROM. And it is also possible to electrically erasable. So it is now E square PROM. So this E here is electrically okay, this is what we have is this E stands for erasable program read-only memory. So whatever program that you have written here can be erased. That erase can be done using ultraviolet rays. This is erasable program read-only memory. This is electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Now here you can able to erase the ROM content which has been programmed earlier using UV lights, whereas here you could able to electrically erase the stored values which is there in the ROM, which will be done at the beginning. So this is read write. Of course, once you erase, you can again program. So once you erase using UV light, you can again program. Here you are erasing it using electrical parameters. Of course, by discharging, you can able to electrically erase the earlier stored values, and you can reprogram. So that's why they are coming under non-volatile read-write memories. So along with this, we have one more this, okay, non-volatile read-write memories, that is flash. So flash are also coming under the category of non-volatile read-write memories, where you can able to read the values at any point of time. If at all, if you want to write something, you can erase everything in a single flash. That is, you can erase the entire memory content in a single flash, and you can write the new data. So these are all coming under this non-volatile read-write memories. So let us have a recap of it. So memories can be static or dynamic. So with the power, the value can be retained, or with the power in place, there is possibility that you may lose the data. And you can have this, okay, read-write memory. This is read-write memory, where you can able to read as well as write it onto this. So here you can see these read-write memories can be random access memories, where you can able to access any element of a memory very randomly. So of course, here you can have again two different categories. It can be SRAM or DRAM. So again, as the name itself indicates, that it is going to statically store the read-write memory. This is random access, and this is dynamic. Of course, why it is dynamic means, okay, the value that is stored will not be there permanently. So you may have to recharge very often so that you can able to retain the value for a longer duration. This is a category of read-write memories. It can be static or it can be dynamic also. This purely depends on how the circuitry of your random access memories. Of course, we have read-only memories, which are usually used for some very important or routine programs that need to be used in any particular system. So that is ROM. So which will be usually programmed. That's why it is called as ROM. And of course, you can have a. This is all non-volatile. In this non-volatile, there is an option for writing also. So in the same ROM, you can erasable ROM, where you can able to erase the program using UV light. If the erosion is happening using the electric field, then it is electrically erasable ROMs. And of course, the last category is flash. So in the coming videos, we shall see the working of individual memories, and then try to understand how do we store the values and how do we read the values.